हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज श्वेता रॉय। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर चैप्टर 8 पार्ट 1 नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस एंड types of natural resources. Here we will start with some of the hard words of the chapter. So you need to practice the pronunciation of these words. Natural resources, raw materials, नेचर, कन्वर्टेड, कोल, पेट्रोलियम, रिन्यूएबल, टाइड, आयरन, कॉपर, एल्यूमिनियम, इनएग्जॉस्टिबल, कंजम्पशन, रिप्लेनिश्ड, accumulated, fossil fuel, nuclear, exhaustible, petroleum, construction, inexpensive, reserve, metal, irrigation, generation, hydroelectricity, appliances, alternative, feature, emission, ingredient, equipment, maintenance, harnessing, geothermal, conserve. So you need to practice these hard words. Here we will understand what is natural resources. Natural resources are useful raw materials that are found in nature and can be converted into useful things. For example, coal, petroleum, water, and sunlight. So by this definition, you can understand that natural resources are raw materials which are found in nature, which we get from the nature, and we can convert those resources into useful things. So those things are called natural resources which we get from the nature. So you have coal, which you get from nature, which is natural resource. This is petroleum, also called crude oil. Then you have water. And sunlight. So these are the things which you get from the nature. And you can convert these things into useful things. You can use these things in many ways. So these are natural resources. Now we have different types of natural resources. So we have renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources means which can be produced continuously in nature, which cannot be exhausted fully. So in that we have solar energy, wind, water, tides. So here you can see, if you are using solar energy, it is not going to exhaust fully. It will be continuously produced, right? So this is renewable resource. In the same way, if we are using wind or water, it is not going to exhaust fully. It is produced continuously and it is renewable resource. But when we talk about coal, so coal, if we are using that coal continuously, it can be exhaust because it cannot be produced continuously. It takes millions of years to produce coal. If you have read about the formation of coal, you will understand the dead plants and animals which go inside the layer of the soils deep, and because of the absence of oxygen and air, and because of the high temperature, high pressure, those dead plants and animals which is buried inside the layer of the soils convert into coal. But these cannot be done in 1 or 2 days, right? It takes millions of years to produce coal, right? So if we will use it continuously, or we are overusing it, it can be exhaust. And we cannot produce coal in a short period of time. The same goes for oil, natural gas, iron, copper, aluminium. So here you can understand the resources which is continuously produced, which cannot be exhausted fully, is renewable resources, and the resources which take a long time to be produced, and if we are overusing that, it can be exhausted. Those are non-renewable resources. Now here you can see the non-renewable resources are further divided into fossil fuels and metallic minerals. Now when we talk about fossil fuels, it is oil, coal and natural gas. That is basically made from, developed from the fossils of the dead plants or animals. That is why it is fossil fuel. And then you have metallic minerals, that is iron, copper, aluminium. So these are all non-renewable resources. So as we discussed, natural resources are of two types, renewable resources. So renewable resources are being produced continuously in nature and are inexhaustible. It cannot be exhausted fully. Now their quantity is not affected by human consumption. That means whatever amount the human are using, it is not going to exhaust fully. It is not going to end fully. And they can be replenished by replenished naturally. That means they will be produced continuously in nature. Renewable resources are also called inexhaustible resources. So examples are sunlight, air, wind and water. They are not going to end. Now we have non-renewable resources, and these are the resources which have accumulated in nature over a very long time and cannot be replaced quickly when exhausted. As I told, it takes millions of years to produce these resources, so it cannot be produced in very short period of time. And it can, if we are overusing it, it can be exhausted fully. Now these non-renewable resources are like fossil fuels, nuclear fuels and natural gas. And these non-renewable resources are also called exhaustible resources, because they can be finished if we are overusing it. It can be exhausted. What are the uses of natural resources? So when we talk about fossil fuels, like we have coal, petroleum, natural gas and nuclear fuel, they are the sources of energy. We use these for as the source of energy. Now minerals are used for various things like construction of roads and buildings. Now metals, which are also the natural resources, they are used for making products like wire, coins, utensils, jewelry, vehicles and machines. Now air is also a natural resource, and air is used for breathing and for the production of wind energy. Water is also a natural resource, and water is used for drinking, irrigation and for the generation of hydroelectricity. Now here you have a question. What percentage of water available on the surface of the earth is fit for human consumption? Find out. So you find out the answer and we will discuss this in our next video. Now, animal and plant products are used in food, clothing and shelter. Now, solar energy, that is also a natural resource and renewable resource. It is used for various household activities like heating water and operating appliances like solar cooker. Here you can see coins are there, and coins are made up of metals. Metals are natural resources. I hope you all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.